from? How did we end up on this rock and where it is going? So there are so many unknowns. And on top of this, now that we are connected and we read so much things about COVID, and the world is such a connected village that the dying words of one person dying at the hands of a police become a national lozenge or international phenomenon across the world. So we are all very connected, and our securities and insecurities resonate and have a lot of ramifications for everyone. So the intention of today's meditation is to grow, one, by understanding energy, using energy, becoming energy master, to be free of our old selves. The old self, which was a smaller self. Smaller means, think of yourself as someone who is locked up inside a body and has got a particular way of thinking. And if this thinking that you have inside your body of the old self enables you to smile, laugh, and help the world which is going through such a crisis, then good, you are already there. And to maintain it, you can use this meditation or get to the next level of energy. The last exercise was about energy. So we are initiating ourselves with energy. And there are three components to energy. The first component is understanding what is energy. Second is how to use it. Awaken it basically first, and then how to use it. And these three components of the energy, they used to be secret. People used to get this information at the end of 20, 30 years of being bullied by a guru in a Himalayas or someplace. And he would treat the disciples as his like slaves, or a teacher who had this knowledge of energy, etc. He would treat his them like slaves in a jungle or a place, like, you know, he would have a place in a hill or somewhere, and people would come, and before his dying, before his death, he would tell the precious secrets of how to get these energy, etc., and how to. So he would choose one person, not everyone, and there are various reasons for that. The first and foremost being that anything that is handed over, energy, the knowledge about energy, is like a hand grenade in the hands of a monkey. We still are monkeys. We are not as evolved. We don't really have wings, so we are not into the next level of evolution. We still are monkeys. We are still fighting. We are still killing others. We are still depreciating others. We are still carrying out judgment calls. We are still seeing us and others as different, even though we are all on the same rock which has been thrown from one eternity point to another eternal point. We are all fellow travelers, and whether we have more thingies, less thingies, we have the same ride. So all this being on the same rock is meant for us to see the point of connection with everyone else, the connection that makes us the same. So the knowledge that we are all sitting on the same planet Earth and going from A to B makes us co-passengers in this cosmic stone or airplane or rocket. We are all co-passengers. And it's not that if the rocket goes down, then anyone of us is going to be spared. Share a common fate, a common destiny. We share everything, but we don't really understand it. So that's where the biggest disease of mankind is. The policeman who was killing the gentleman who was different than him in the color of the skin, because he did not identify with the person. he was seeing this color person is of a different color than mine. So even seeing the common point, hey, the blood between this behind the skin is the same as me. And he certainly wasn't seeing, oh, this person could be my son or friend or someone. Otherwise, no one is killing themselves. As people are, deluded people are. So that also happens. That happens when you let go of the physical body. But in truth, no one can kill himself or he or anyone. People can deal with the body. People cannot deal with the unknown, enormous amount of the energy which goes beyond E is equal to MC squared. Hidden insider. People cannot deal with that. So people can work only with the death of the body. And that happens. It's tragic, but not so tragic. Death is not so much of a tragedy. It looks really ugly. And you have to be sick mentally to be able to enjoy it at any level. Angels, etc., they don't enjoy the sickness of these people, even though they see, oh, this is freeing them. So this energy, think of yourself as enormous amount of energy locked in this human body, locked on this planet, enclosed in this universe with its particular rules. So the first thing you have to see is that to become and to be able to awaken this energy, which we are going to be calling Kundalini, the art of self-realization, when you are able to see yourself in everyone else, and then you cannot hurt the other person. You're not going to be cutting off your left hand. Hopefully, no. But if you will see that your neighbor is an extension of the same physical organism of which you are a part, then the chances of your hurting the other person are going to be very less. So we are going to be focusing on the energy inside to awaken our unlimited potential to be able to love everything and everyone. Without a judgment call. Oh, this person looks dark, white, this, that. You see another person, you awaken so much amount of energy inside yourself that it brings clarity to you. I know of a lot of energy people, and they are locked on. They have a restriction of the mind, which is, I am an energy teacher, or I am an energy healer, or I can do this with energy. And that is the first, I would say, challenge that you have to overcome. Because the moment you start saying, my energy is better, it's so good, I'm a healer, you are this, but then this understanding of the energy is creating a block which sets you apart and sets you to be taken down by the universe, which is your higher self. Why? And I'll give you a very funny example. It seems that everyone gets these emails. Oh, you have won $1 million, $1 billion, and all you have to do is you have to send to the relatives of King of Nigeria some amount of money to his relatives who have lost the kingdom and different stories. But at the end of it is, you have been selected. You are the chosen one. Or you can get an SMS. And I know people who have fallen for this scam all the time. Like, you would think that this scam is not working. It works all the time. The basic concept is, you're told you have won a lottery. And immediately, even when you know, surprisingly, you know that the chances of this happening, it's too good to be true, etc. But millions of such emails are sent, and 2-3% are hit and they get the response. And that's enough to maintain this cycle. So the point is this, it seems that when we get an email saying that you have won a lottery, you have been chosen, you have been selected, we immediately, a sense of I awakens in us. I am special. I am different. For others,
If your neighbor will tell us, oh, I just got an email saying that I won a lottery and I've got or I've won a trip to Bahamas, etc., you would be laughing, what a stupid guy. But when you get it, there is an internal part of us that really wants to be treating myself. I'm special. I'm better. My energy is better. Then energy just becomes another thing. My energy heals, yours doesn't. And it draws a line between you and the others, decreasing your energy and you not getting where you want it to be. I know lots of energy teachers. I went in Vegas, etc. If you'll go, even in the midst of cities, in the most prizes of places, you'll see chakra healing and kundalini this and that, and it's all basically in Reiki and this, and it's all good as long as it is an act of love. But when it becomes I and this energy of mine is special, it has a special vibration to it, and I like these energy of when I'm in a church or this, or there are places around Phoenix where there are special energy vortexes and all that, I will go there. And then you are becoming a prisoner of the energy, and you're becoming a prisoner. Energy and enlightenment has just become another thing that you think, that is the latest model of the car or house or dress or something that you think you own and sets you out, makes you special. And this feeling we have become, our whole society is infected and is really, really very afraid to acknowledge that not me, but everyone is special. The whole universe is special. There is nothing on this planet which is not special. Nothing. My finger, your finger, anything on the planet, if it is in existence, it is special. You think that a grain of, let's say, salt or sand is not special. There are millions of billions of such sand, but it works out that every snowflake, every sand, etc., everything is unique. They seem to be not special, and not special in that it seems to be like, but everything is special. Do you know what are the molecules in sand and how they are moving? At enormous speeds they are moving, but the sand seems to be in the same place. But inside everything, there is a huge amount of energy, because that is how the electrons are traveling. The thing itself might not be traveling, but the electrons are traveling at huge vibrations of you. So to get to awaken energy inside yourself, you have to understand that there is a dormant energy. Just by being present on this planet, having a body, there is energy inside of you. Now think of energy as, what is your body? 90% water? I'm giving an example, but it's going to be marginal. So 90% of your body is water, but water also has got electrons which vibrate. And the water inside most of our bodies, even though it is flowing around, it's in a very constricted space, and so be it. Because that means that blood is not flowing out, and blood is your life force, so be it. So this water, it's like in a small locked area, and this water has got a frequency. Now, when you increase the frequency of water, what happens? The same water molecules, they become steam. What happens to steam? It transcends. It rises up. Water is here. You give it heat, energy, it rises up. It becomes a cloud, and then of course it comes down after cooling off. But to start a new cycle, so the energy inside you and the knowledge of energy inside you, our first intention is that with the knowledge of the energy that now we know is inside us, we have to change, awaken our inner resources so that we vibrate at a level of a different higher frequency, so that we can transcend our body, this earth, everything which is bounding or binding you down. We are able to transcend. In transcending, you resolve the all the problems of your life. Why? Because you have these problems. You hate your job, you don't like your relationship, or you want a relationship, you want this, you want that. And you are in this framework of mind. We are all prisoners of likes and dislikes. But when, with the help of energy, we transcend, not only biologically, we go above our body, we escape and have a different perspective. Oh my God, the earth looks beautiful from above. It doesn't at all look like the place where people are fighting and COVID is happening around. It looks like a perfect, heavenly, beautiful place to inhabit. And your job, with this knowledge of energy and with transcendence, is to look at these, at the planet Earth, at the universe, at yourself and your life. They are all the same. Your body is the planet. The universe and whatever is happening, those millions and billions of things which are happening, is the reflection of the universe. So when, with transcendence, you achieve that level, you take a look at the universe and you see the beauty of everything on the planet and in the universe, you have a different outlook, point of view, and you see all your problems, all the things that cause you to feel sad, unhappy, distressed. It could be a relationship, it could be a job thing, it could be anything that gives you a stress and you don't like it. You see it as a blessing. You see it as a challenge, because that is what people on this planet do. We create for ourselves problems, then we solve them, then we feel happy. That's all. Who wants to take a look at naked rocks? What is so great about? I can even understand going to, let's say, to Paris, even though like France, I consider was the most overadvertised, overhyped the place, etc. There's a special sell out there for people who are sort of disoriented and like really are depressed because they came to France and Paris thinking it would be romantic, etc. But they came with that idea, and there's a special self. There's a special place which deals with people who have said that because they came with such expectations, and France is basically not so vibrant in my view as Italy is. So create these problems. Oh, I'll go to Paris and be happy, and then we are usually not so much happy as we had expected it to be happy. And my question is, what's so big about looking at plain rocks? Nothing. But you would be surprised that when you climb the Himalayas or any mountain, you see only rocks around it. That's all. But people are willing to die for that, and they constantly do. There are I was reading an article that there are number of dead bodies on the way to that last climb to Himalayas is somewhere in hundreds. They can't be collected. And there are thousands who have died trying to get up to a rock. And the other thing is, you need to be rich to be attempting a Himalayan. There is no point. You have to climb the Himalaya inside you and transcend. Go above your restrictions and limitations of thinking that stop you from blessing or seeing as a blessing whatever has hurt you, is hurting you, or will hurt you. So energy is a transcendence tool. And the knowledge that you, me, everyone has got more than the E is equal to MC square energy inside us has been proven by physics. And it is there at any level. The strongest person is not the one who picked up the most kilograms. It's the lady who picked up a truck for a few seconds when her child crawled up inside it. You need enormous amount of it. She doesn't know how she did. So, but all that power is locked up inside her. So we are going to be first initiating ourselves with the knowledge that we are going to be using energy as a tool of transcendence above ourselves, our limited self, which says, I have anger, I have pain, I have fear, I don't like this, I like this, I want this, I don't want this, and the whole life we are like a yo-yo. I want this, I want to avoid this, I want this. That is why Buddha said very easily, Sarvam Dukham, the whole world is full of pain. It doesn't matter. We have these things that if someone had millions, billions, etc. 3 days ago, a very well-known guy who was married to Elizabeth Hurley, one of the most beautiful women supposed to be on the planet, he committed suicide. He was just 50-something, my age. He jumped. And he was a good guy. He was giving to charity and he still committed suicide. He should have given more aid. Like if it was so bad, then he should have given. You have to give till it hurts. It hurts so much that you want to live. That's my, I would say, incorrect judgment. But once a person has rid of this body, then he has a second chance. I'm pretty sure he will have a second chance. He'll come again. And the next time he will be more mindful, even more mindful. He was a good guy. He gave to charity millions of dollars, to political parties also, but also to charity. So to unlock and transcend using energy, the first symbol that we had done in the previous exercise, and we will repeat it very briefly, is that first you get the knowledge that this energy is locked and it's everything and everywhere, even including in a piece of sand which seems to be dormant, but it has got electrons vibrating. So the knowledge starts to set us free at the first level. The knowledge that I'm going to be, energy is everywhere, it's inside me. In fact, I am energy of what? We find out. And this energy inside me can be unlocked so that I can transcend, go above. And that's always easy to do. We don't have to die to go above ourselves. And the intent is that with transcendence, I come back to this body as a better myself. Having killed, having left the old you, the old you which has got this fear, anger, pain, I like this, I like, all these things which have caused me so much amount of pain, because if I say I like something, that means I want it, and if I get it, I want it more and more and more, I become a prisoner. If I don't like it, I want to avoid it more and more and more, and my whole life has become a sarvam dukham, total pain. And we can think that someone has money, so they have less pain, etc. No. I read about the last days of total dictators of one of the, I think it was Korea, and his last days were totally hell. He was thinking that the other people around him are out to get him. He was shoveling off blame from one thing to another. Anyone who would have any different point of view was considered dissent. He had been a revolutionary. So he slowly killed off, just like Stalin had, all his revolutionary people. So he was miserable. He had total power. And he was miserable, cold, afraid, and stole so much amount of money from the political party that he was leading to Swiss banks, that when he was killed ultimately by another guy who got a paranoid that this guy is going to kill me, it was the Ministry of Defense in 1980, this happened. And he killed, and they couldn't find, he killed the other person also, his bodyguard who knew this Swiss guard keys, etc. So all the money was lost, basically. So the point is, we think that someone is happy, but everyone is after likes, dislikes, and is in a state of pain. And when we are all connected on this planet even better, then the pain of one becomes the pain of many. So our job with our energy transcendence, because energy is a tool in the wrong hands, it's going to be like a grenade in the hands of a monkey. The monkey is your own mind. So we have to, even before we start, we have to just close our eyes and give the promise. And the more powerful or pure the promise that you are going to make to yourself, the more you will understand and the more energy will be flowing through you. And it is very, very simple. So we focus on the symbol of Om. Om is like a three. You can also focus on any symbol of God. Any symbol of God, because God right now represents the higher you. So when you don't spit at the photograph of your father, or you don't spit at the photograph, at least on a dollar bill or something, because these things are more than paper. They are representation, and your mind connects with these entities or the value of money or the life of your father, etc. So things are not things. Right now, you are going to be focusing on Om, which is like a three, in the center of your forehead, the third eye of intuition. With closed eyes, the intention is, may I awaken the energy of enlightenment leading me to transcendence above my old self, so that I become a pure angel with open wings of love, light, and laughter, so that I can serve everything and everyone with unconditional energy of love. Unconditional energy. May I serve? May I be an instrument of spreading love, light, and laughter? May I be a pure instrument? May I be a pure instrument? May I be a pure instrument of energy, of love, light, and laughter? May the angels, may the higher self help me. So be it. Om Tat Sat. Om Tat Sat. Om Tat Sat. Slowly open your eyes. And the symbol that we had used the last time was the snake, like an S, arising from your coccyx, from your tailbone. So first, we will do some breathing exercises just 7 times and awaken the S of the snake. Kundalini represents the path that the energy takes. It represents going across the chakras, which are your energy centers, but also your focal modes of thinking. Because when you think, oh, I love my mother, your lower chakra opens up. You think, I love all the people on the, your chakra of relationship opens. You love, oh, I love the father, son who has given me life, your third chakra. You say, my heart is a church of joy, a synagogue of happiness, a temple of serving, and your heart opens up. You say, I want to communicate love, your fifth chakra. You say, I want to see only love, your sixth chakra. You say, you are blessed, your seventh chakra opens up. So there are different ways. There are physical ways of imagining color, etc. We are going with the most sophisticated in mind. You are going with the intention to achieve a different, a higher energetical you. So closing eyes, thinking of the S, trace with Om Namo Shivaya, O in the coccyx, in the lowest part of spine, in the lower part of your body, where all your sexual energy is dormant. O, it initiates and it climbs up. Om Namo. It's going like an earth. Shivaya. It's going up. It's going up. From your sexual energy, it becomes the any place that, any chakra that the snake energy touches, opens up like a flower, opening you up. Om Namo. And you're becoming a total loving, healing person. Om Namo Shiva. Om Namo Shiva. Om Namo Shiva. And now with your breathing, so that your life force kicks into it. You are not using the breathing of the oxygen. Beneath this mask of facade of oxygen is an energy of pure love floating around everyone, present in everything. You draw it slowly. Oh, it goes inside your nostrils. Oh, ma, it drops to your coccyx. Ma, and it starts to rise up. Namo Shiva. Oh, ma, Namo Shiva. Oh, breathe in. Oh, my, it goes inside, deep inside yourself, dropping down like a stone to the spine base. Namo Shiva, going up like a snake. Om Namo Shiva. Now that your heart is open, you send love so that there are no blocks, there is nothing which will stop the rocket of energy to leave the planet. You send love to all the people who have played any role in you, your mother, your source of life, to your father, to all your partners. You send love. Oh, breathing. Oh, ma. Namo to your heart. Your heart becomes a temple of joy. And you spread love to everything and everyone because you are becoming an energy of love. And your heart is the brimstone. Your heart is the shining source of this eternal divine light. Om Namo, your heart opens. You send love to the mother Shiva. Om Namo to all your partners, male and female, to anyone who has played any part from your heart. Shiva. Om, breathe in. Om Namo, from your heart send out love to all the male energy on the Shiva. To all the poor, sick and sad people, all people who have been born, who are being born, who will born, who have sarvam dukham, who are in this state of pain, you help them to free. You wish them that may God they be free like I am of all pain, fear, anger of the past. Om Namo Shiva. Now you pray to the goddess of energy, to the god of energy rather, Shiva and Kali or Parvati. And you pray for this energy to be awakened. God has got many faces, the healer god, the judgmental god, and we personalize like them, Mr. Jesus, Mr. Krishna, Mr. Rama, Mr. Buddha. We personalize them, we give them human attributes. But right now, deep inside yourself, this energy has got no form. It is indescribable. And it is shooting from your heart to everything and everyone. So, with an open heart, you bless everything and everyone, and you fill your inner universe with pure harmony. Your body, which is your inner universe, reflecting the external universe, you become full of harmony and joy and gratitude for the gift of this amazing life in this human body. Om Namo Shiva. You offer your life and all the energy blessings to all the divine beings. Nothing is non-divine, so you offer it to everything in it. Om Namo and gratitude, love, divine love from your heart to Shiva. You do it with the breathing. Om Namo Shiva. You dissolve. Shiva, you dissolve. Om Namo. You are not focused on the body with its five senses. You dissolve your total love for everything and everyone. Om Namo Shiva. Now, know that the path that the energy takes up, like the letter S. Now you are going to, with our help, you are going to initiate ourselves with the symbol of Reiki, Chakra, Chokure, of pranic energy. The first symbol, energy symbol, is not the S. S is the path of the Kundalini. The power to love and heal everyone and everything, especially yourself. So that S is the path. But when you achieve transcendence and you look down at yourself from the crown of the head, this is what I want you to be seeing. This eternal spiral, starting off from your coccyx, from the lowest part of your spine, you're going up in a spiral circle. It will look like S. If someone from the front of you will look at your energy, it will look like this. But from the top, it will look like this, or top will be like this, but it's going to go around like this, starting from your cockpit. So you're sitting like this, from between your perineum, at the end of the cockpit somewhere, the energy is going to go around like this. Om Namo Shiva. It's going to go up like a vortex, and vortex is your lowest part, where all your sexual energy, I want this, I don't want this, I want this and more and that, all that is now becoming transmuted to pure energy of divine love with which you want to serve the universe, not yourself, the universe, which is everyone in your life. So to do that, you are going to take a look at this symbol. It's called chakra or chokure. It's the first symbol, and the intention is that may I be free from being blocked in one body, one point, to become free of all, go beyond all pain of the body, emotions in the heart, thoughts in the head, and become an infinite love, light, and laughter for everything and everyone. Once more, this symbol, it means I'm going beyond body, mind, and intellect to be one with Shiva, or the infinity of love, which is God. Having seen the symbol, initiate yourself by focusing in the middle of your forehead, and with closed eyes, draw it, saying Om Namo Shiva. See it vibrating and turning around. It's starting to churn for most of you. In the center of the forehead, imagine the chakra, the spiral of infinity. And the meaning is, I go beyond, I arise, I awaken in myself the energy of pure love, light, and laughter. I go beyond body at a level of stomach. I go beyond my emotions at a level of our heart. I go beyond my intellect. So it's a three-dimensional energy graph that I'm giving to you. From the top, if you will take a look at yourself, you will see the energy going around like this, taking you beyond. If you will see from the front, you will see it like a S, but it's a spiral staircase. Like the double helix of the DNA. Probably that's the best example for you too. So starting, focusing on the center of the forehead, see the symbol of chakra. Start seeing as you feel inside yourself, oh, may I awaken the power to be in, to be like and be infinite Shiva. And Shiva is infinity of love, infinity of divine love. Om Namo Shiva. 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 Now switch or take this spiral to the base of the coccyx, to the base of your spine, to the lowest part of your body, which when you sit joins with the planet when you're sitting cross-legged. And imagine that from there, Om Namo Shiva. It's going up like rapidly, freeing your stomach area right now. Om, your sexual energy is changing and going around in your stomach. Om, rising to your heart, opening your heart. At your stomach, all your problems of having fears and not non-acceptances of whatever has happened in the last, you can now absorb, assimilate, and go beyond. Your heart is opening. Namo, Namo, Namo. Shiva, it is going through your mind, through every brain cell where you're thinking patterns and changing them. Om Namo Shiva, going to infinity. Om Namo Shiva. Om Namo Shiva. So you feel the vortex of energy inside you. It's in your body, but it's not your body. Om Namo Shiva. And you can start to vibrate a little. Start Om Namo Shiva. Om Namo Shiva. Vibration. Cleaning you of all pain, fear, anger of the past. As you become an instrument of this divine energy, which is in everything and everyone. Om Namo Shiva. Om Namo Shiva. Om Namo Shiva. Om Namo Shiva. Om Namo Shivaya. Now I want you to slowly open your eyes. Now Om is going to be here at your crown. Your seventh chakra is already open. These exercises are very, they will open whether you believe or not. However you are doing, your intention will open. Your maintenance of it will require constant laughter of the heart. That's the fertilizer that you need for it. But right now, Om over out here and Namo above the universe, so that we go above this body. Three more times with the body, because I have broken your attention. Three more times in the coccyx, starting off. Om Namo Shivaya as a vortex. Om Namo Shivaya. Imagine that you are riding this vibration. You are going up this spiral staircase. Om, there is a mini you of small golden ball of energy, which is you, starting off at the base of the spine, coccyx. Om, and you are riding up. Om, you are seeing your stomach area energy. You are seeing your heart energy. You are seeing your mind level energy. Shivaya. Again, you go down again. It's a cycle. Om Namo Shivaya. Om Namo Shivaya. Now, as you have reached the top, you don't go down. You start your Om at your crown of the head. Om. You go above this planet in a vast circle, encompassing, and it's a huge. You're embracing everything. You're going around the universe now, the planet first, and then you're embracing everything. The planet represents your body and whatever your thoughts are. The universe represents everything that you cannot control in your physical body and which is happening around you in life, on this universe. You embrace it. Namo, you go around it. Shivai, you go beyond the beyond to be one with God. And as you go towards Shiva, this sense of being divine energy and only divine energy seeps to you, infects you, you become one. Towards what you go, that's what you become. So in the coccyx first of all, Om Namo Shiva. Going up to the Sahasra, the seventh chakra on the crown of the head. Om Namo Shiva. And you can use your breathing also. You can use your breathing. Om Namo Shiva. Shiva, you become one. Now, your starting point is not the coccyx, but your seventh chakra, the Sahasra chakra, the crown of the head. O over there, as a group with it. Om. You're already starting to go around the planet Earth. Ma. Namo, across the universe and the creation. Namo. Shiva, you're going beyond these restrictions and borders, you become one with the divine love, both which is inside you and around you. Shiva, you see yourself in everything, you see everyone in yourself. Om Namo Shiva. Om Namo Shiva. You are going around still in a circle. Around the planet, Om. Around the universe, Namo. Around infinity, approaching infinity of love, which is Shiva, and becoming one. Your thinking process is becoming only divine energy of Shiva's love. Or any love. Om Namo Shiva. Om Namo Shiva. Om Namo Shiva. Now, in this astral energetic form, I want you to feel different energy levels with different names of God. Adonai. So that you don't become, oh, only Hinduism has the key. All religions have the same key. Adonai, Adonai, Adonai. Yehovah. Keep on going around. Yehovah. Shiva. Oh, the universe. universe has got a lot of pluses and everything in your life. It's not pure harmony, but now you're embracing everything and everything is becoming a pure harmony. Om Namo Shiva. As you go around the universe, Allahu Akbar. Om Namo Shiva. Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Adona, Om Mani Padme Hum, Om Mani Padme Hum, Om, just pure Om. The vibration of the universal energy, that's just what an energy is. And you are at a very core, just energy, infinite energy of love, which presently is going through a life, an adventure on this planet, going through ups and downs. You are becoming who you truly are, total energy of love, willing and ready to serve everything and everyone unconditionally. Infinity. You see that the whole universe is in you, that we are all connected. The deeper level, the same E is equal to MC square energy is inside every one of us. It is common. We may look different at a body level. We may act different in a body level. But we are all connected and we are all part of the same subconsciousness of love. But that subconsciousness is deep inside you and it is awakening. That is what Kundalini is. The awakening of the power to love everything and everyone. And you use Om Namo Shiva. You can use any holy chanting to awaken. Amen. Our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done. On heaven as in earth. On this day give us our daily bread and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those that trespass against us. Lead us from temptation. Deliver us from every time in the power of the Lord. Pater Noster, Cheers Alice, Antifitin Novantra, Tadventiate Nintua, Yad Voluntas, Putin Chalu Inter, Panim Nostrum, Kotai Dunam the Nos, Edimite Novitivita Nos, Sikutin Novitori, Spiritoris, Indanos, and Kasa Tentatis. వచ్చిన చేసిన ప్రస్లావించి త్రిభుజ శాస్త్రీనాశిస్తే ఓం త్రయంబకం యజామి సుగంధిం పుష్టివర్ధనం ఉర్వారుకునాం మోక్షేమాం ఓం భవరు సత్వాన్య భర్గవ దివసదిని ద్యో యోనాప్ స్తుత ఓం సతమాతం సుఖయ మృత్యు మాజ్యోతిర్గమ ఓం శాంతి. Slowly come back. So the three things that we have learned. The first thing, for the symbols of energy to work, you need the clarity that this energy you will use as a transcendence tool. Not to awaken the self. I have this energy now. I am better. I am a healer. I am this and that. Anything that you say, I am this and that, will keep you a prisoner and not open your energy as you would like. Or it can open, but it can lead to different ways of thinking that may be irrational. So instead of saying, I want this energy to do this and that, and there have been instances of people praying to God for energy and these, and they get it. God is a loving God. He gives it. All the demons in Hindu mythology, they got their powers by praying to Brahma. They prayed and they prayed and they prayed, and then when the Brahma came, they would say, I would want this kingdom and I want these, and I want the ability that no one should be able to kill me. And Brahma, you would usually say, even I am a Brahma, but even I will go through cycles of creation and uncreation or death. So then they will say that, oh Brahma, then at least make it so that no man can kill us, because we are demons, we are not afraid of, but no animal, no angel, no demigod or semigod, no one can kill us, no other god, and you, they definitely also do. So all the demons, they got their power by praying. That is why energy is considered to be dangerous. It is not handed out so readily as in these times of, but these are very different, very challenging times. That is why they are being shared across. So you have to first understand that you take upon the energy lesson with a commitment that I will use this energy as a tool to transcend, so I am a better person. Not that I'll become a healer or something. Or if you do, good, but don't make it a big thing. Secondly, focusing on the S and Om. S gives the path, but any ritual is a technique, and any technique can go right and wrong, and it doesn't matter. Some of the prayers that I read, I didn't read them out fully well, but the intention was there, so it's all good. So the intention will serve you through, not the right technique. The intention is that I want to awaken this energy, to see the same energy in everything and everyone, to see inside myself the others, and to see myself in others, and then I won't be hurting. I will be living for the well of all. That is a simple thing. Energy is a uniting notion. Just like the planet Earth is holding all of us, just like the sun is the first source of biological energy, is giving light to everyone without any condition, so are you by awakening this energy inside you. Om is a really powerful symbol once you have got the clarity, which was shared with you in the first 30 minutes. Om is a very powerful system, but it works powerfully because it awakens inside you your own potential, not inside the others. It awakens inside you. And you see Om in the center of your forehead means what? That all your thinking powers, those vast 90% not used, this, all those powers are laser-like fixed on that symbol. And what is that symbol of? Infinite love. That's what God is. That's what Kundalini is. That's what everything at the end of the day is. When you focus with a laser on these symbols that represent something more than that symbol for you, then you are initiated. And then your focus is changing. So S is the way it goes up, like this, like a snake. That's why it's shown everywhere. But right now we are doing the vortex exercise, the energy going round and round like a double helix of the DNA, changing your DNA of thinking so that you, every time that the energy goes through these chakras, these are modes of your thinking. So you go beyond your, you drop your anger at your mother, you're free when you awaken with Om. Then you go beyond your anger at all the people in your life and you're free. And then you go with gratitude towards the father, son, at the level of the stomach, and you're free. Then your heart opens up to what it is meant to be, a church of joy, a synagogue of happiness, shining, blinding, eternal divine light to everyone from your heart. And then you communicate only love, opening your intuition, and your way of thinking is now a blessing. So these are the seven chakras and the energy when it is going around in this cleaning up. Once all these have been, once the physical body is balanced and full of harmony, then only you can go beyond. So then you place the starting point in the Sahasra chakra, and then Om Namo Shivaya, and now you are going around not in the biological but in the astral plane. You have to believe it. And who is there when you close your eyes and you're done this exercise will not see the universe? You will see, for sure, guaranteed. Om Namo Shivaya at a biological level, then Om Namo Shivaya because at an astral level, you are getting even more closer to the Shiva, which is deep inside yourself. So you see the universe, and when you are going towards Shiva, even when you touch with that electricity for 1 microsecond, you get jolted and your old self is electrocuted. You come back a new you. Now, right now, you are free of this pain, fear, anger. You have to maintain it by using over out here the spiral energy, going beyond your body, mind, and intellect. And all the time, doing Om Namah. So you draw the spiral over out here, Om Namah. And when your thinking is like laser focused on any symbol of God, be it cross, be it the spiral, be it Allah, be it the Star of David, each has a different vibration, but the intention is the same. It opens your heart. And as you move, you are free. You can go around your body, your universe, and you are full of gratitude. What does going around mean? It means that you can embrace it. It's inside you. There is no one on this planet who is not inside you. So the suffering of everyone is your suffering. The joy of everyone is also your joy. And right now, when there are so many news about things are tense and this, and that's the way the news works, you become a center of radiating pure joy to everything and everyone. You are an energy of divine love working through this body to spread joy, love, life, and laughter. Laughter is, if after doing this energy exercise you can laugh easily, means you got it. If you become serious about this energy and this how, you haven't got it. So to get it, you have to do it at the end till you're free of all your smallness and are able to laugh and share the energy, the shining heart light with everything and everyone. So I'm stopping now. And if